Michelangelo's David. It might be hard to believe, but when you finally sweep through the endless reproductions and apparently hilarious knickknacks,
that's my brother's birthday present sorted.
There is a real masterpiece to gaze upon. A genuine work of genius. And more than that, it is a symbol of a city. Florence. But David also has a volatile past. It has served more than one meaning, and has even threatened war.
I'm Jasper Roscoe, and this is the story of the most famous sculpture in the world. In 1410, it was decided that the Duomo, Florence's cathedral, was to be decorated with sculptures of Old Testament heroes. They would stand up there on the buttresses of these small domes. So naturally, the greatest sculptor in Florence at the time, Donatello, was originally commissioned to create a sculpture of Jacob in terracotta. Terracotta is a relatively cheap material generally used for plant pots or roof tiles, as is actually exemplified by the roof of the Duomo. However, it was to be painted white to look like marble. This decision makes a lot of sense, really. Why spend a lot of money on a massive block of marble for a sculpture that's going to be up there? No one would be able to see the detail or tell the difference. After Donatello's work, other sculptors were commissioned to produce similar ones, until in 1464, the committee that were in charge of decorating the Duomo decided to step it up a notch by buying a massive block of marble for a 17-foot sculpture of David.
A follower of Donatello's was originally commissioned to sculpt David, but did very little before abandoning the project for unknown reasons. Then another sculptor was given the job, but he passed it up, complaining that the marble had too many imperfections.
The committee were out of sculptors and out of ideas, so they just left it, exposed to the elements lying flat in a courtyard nearby. David would spend 35 years in his stony womb.
Meanwhile, 10 years after the committee had given up on any plans to create a sculpture of David, Michelangelo was born. He was born in a little unnoteworthy town 100 kilometers from Florence to a family of failed bankers. Through the husband of his nanny, Michelangelo became interested in carving. He showed promise from a young age and became a pupil of Ghirlandaio, one of the greatest painters in Florence at the time. By the age of 18, he had carved some minor sculptures for the Medicis, the ruling family of Florence. By the age of 23, he had lived in Rome and completed numerous commissions to such a high standard that people were beginning to murmur the word genius. And so, when he was in Florence at the age of 26, Michelangelo had a reputation worthy of consideration for any project. He was the right man in the right place when the Duomo committee finally decided that they wanted to do something about their massive block of marble that was now infamous and nicknamed the Giant. The marble was raised up on its feet, and anyone in Florence who knew what they were talking about were asked to inspect the stone and offer an opinion. Even Leonardo da Vinci was asked. It had been badly damaged from being left outside and had many imperfections in the first place. Yet when Michelangelo saw the stone, he was of the opinion that there was still potential for a 17-foot David, and that he was the man to execute it. He was right.
I quote the words of Giorgio Vasari, Michelangelo's contemporary biographer. To tell the truth, this work eclipsed all other statues. No other sculpture can be compared to this David, which Michelangelo completed with so much measure and beauty and so much skill. For the contours of its legs are extremely beautiful, along with the splendid articulations and grace of its flanks. A sweeter and more graceful pose has never been seen that could equal it, nor have feet, hands, a head ever been produced which so well match all the other parts of the body in skill of workmanship or design. To be sure, anyone who sees this statue need not be concerned with seeing any other piece of sculpture done in our time or in any other period by any other artist.
David is a truly magnificent sculpture. To be dwarfed by something so perfect is an incredible experience. It is beautifully balanced, symmetrical, and proportioned. But this is a sculpture by Michelangelo, and nothing by his hand isn't. What is surprising, though, is the detail. Remember, this is a sculpture that was going to be placed on the cathedral roof. No one would be able to make out the veins on David's hand. I suppose its existence we would have to put down to Michelangelo's pride in his work, to deliver the very best without exception. His interpretation of the subject is also fascinating. This is the David from the story of David and Goliath, the boy who takes on the giant with a sling. The sling is in David's hands. He holds a rock in his right hand. His expression is tense, focused, and engaged. He hasn't fought Goliath yet, but he is ready for the fight. This analysis looks at David as a work of art. However, if you want to understand this colossal figure, you need to recognize that he has always been more than that. For example, in the immediate aftermath of its creation, David was as much a logistical nightmare as he was a work of art.
When Michelangelo finished David in 1504, a group of the greatest artists and architects in Florence were summoned together to work out how to put such a large sculpture on top of a cathedral. You see, despite there being plans for sculptures to go up there for 100 years, no one actually knew how to do it. There was probably also a feeling that a magnificent sculpture like that is wasted on top of a cathedral. People need the opportunity to see it up close. And so it was placed here, in front of the Palazzo Vecchio, the town hall of Florence in the most important square.
This is not to say that placing him here would be easy either. Some significant innovations had to be made to transport David in one piece through the streets of Florence from one side of town to the other. This change of position also crucially changed the sculpture's meaning. On the Duomo, David would have served a religious function. He is a Christian symbol, but in front of the Palazzo Vecchio, Florence's very heart, David represents the city. He symbolizes it. Here, the sculpture is immediately read with political connotations, and David's sideways glance is directed south, towards Rome. He communicates that the Republic of Florence may be small, but like David, she has God on her side and is ready for a fight. However, it is also possible that David wasn't seen at the time as a symbol of the city, but as a symbol of her rulers. Michelangelo's biographer Vasari also explained that in the Old Testament, David had defended his people and governed them with justice. So too, those who govern this city should courageously defend it and govern it with justice. The rulers of Florence at the time and throughout the majority of the Renaissance were the Medici family. David, to a certain extent, symbolizes them. Hence why in the year that the sculpture was unveiled, it was pelted with stones in an anti-Medici protest. Then in 1527, after a revolution that dethroned the Medici, the left arm of David was smashed into three pieces. The arm that holds the sling. Without it, he is just a standing nude, no threat to anyone. The rulers of Florence silenced.
David is more of an icon today than he ever was before. He's no longer one sculpture, but a mascot for the city of Florence. He symbolizes her creative triumph and embodies a collective spirit. From the highest point of Florence, he watches over a city, and so he should.